Ahead.
I was made to understand that the annex, which indicates all these onerous provisions that we have identified, which is attached to the original concession agreement, was never signed. Tama ba yun?
The concession agreement was never signed.
No, no, no. The annex, which stipulates these onerous provisions, which they identified, were never signed. Yung especially yung provision of yung no government interference or intervention. Doon sa 1997 yun.
Okay, na may copy ka ng letter of undertaking.
Hindi, baka MWSS siguro or DOJ can provide us with that. That's all. Mr. Chair, yun lang para makita rin natin.
Ang sinasabi ni Congressman Barbers that the letter of undertaking was never signed.
Yes, yung annex doon sa 1997 concession agreement.
Kasi ako, wala akong nakikitang letter.
Nandoon yung mga sinasabi ng DOJ na onerous eh. So, ibig sabihin, 1997 pa pala, meron ng provision doon na sinasabi na hindi pwede mag-intervene o mag-interfere ang government doon sa rate rebasing. Tama? So, hindi pala bago yon. Kasi we never saw that eh. Yes. Akala na ako personally, I thought, Mr. Chair, that that provision was only in the undertaking of 2007, which was signed in 2010. So, 1997 pa siya. Yun.
Ah, ito po yun. Nakalagay po dito, Exhibit D, letter D. Tama, hindi usign. Pero ang nakalagay dito, the Republic shall not interfere with the mechanisms contained in Article 9 of the agreement relating to the setting of rates and connection charges for water and sewerage services. Tama ka, Congressman Barbers, hindi po signed. But it should have been signed by Secretary De Ocampo, Secretary of Finance. So it's never signed. DOJ, was it signed? Yes, MWSS.
Mr. Chairman, it was signed and we will just give the committee a copy of the thank signed you. Performance undertaking.
Thank you, thank you. Okay. Yes, Congressman Bersaga.
What is the position of the MWSS? Will this be binding? Considering that the document was signed by the Secretary of Finance on behalf of the Republic of the Philippines?
Mr. Chair, I understand that this is the undertaking of the Government Republic of the Philippines, represented by Department of Finance.
Well, does the Secretary of Finance have this authority? It's not even by the President, under the authority of the President. Republic of the Philippines by Roberto D. Ocampo, Secretary of Finance. If cabinet secretaries could execute these documents validly, that would be too dangerous to our country.
Actually, just for the information, yes, this was signed on behalf of the Republic. There are undertakings, international agreements that can be signed by Secretary of Finance in terms of loans and financial applications.
But that should be by authority of the President because cabinet secretaries are considered alter ego of the President.
Opo, by authority po to.